So together with this plane I bought a starter unit. This starter unit was used, as you can see on this video, to start the plane engine. This is the starter unit. It's fully original. It came along with the plane. The idea behind this thing was to start the propeller. On this car you have a petrol engine together with a hydraulic unit. This hydraulic unit supplies pressure to this hydraulic motor. This output shaft from the hydraulic pump fits inside the propeller hub from the plane. As you can see, there are some wear marks already where the plane was engaged with the propeller. To activate this pump, you could pull this lever. So then it was not pulled, it was steady, I guess. And when you pull it, it will start spinning. There are some hydraulic hoses, inlet, outlet. It's now supported by a wooden stick, but of course as you engage it, you hold two hands on these handles and you can move it around, because it can rotate here and it can rotate around the shaft. So what do we have on this car? Petrol tank, an oil fill, one cylinder engine, a throttle, I think. On there. Pull start, choke, exhaust, start more, inlet, even the stickers are still in place. Engine maintenance. So 8 horsepower. So this is the hydraulic oil storage tank, yes, breather on top. So this unit looks like this unit is quite original and complete and more or less ready to go. But before I will start or activate it, I will make sure it will be 100% good. So we'll clean the gas tank, check engine oil. Maybe refresh the hydraulic oil. Today I would like to see what's going on below the inlet cover from the inlet engine inlet filter. It looks like this is quite rusty, so I will screw it back. Looks like we can replace this filter map. This is additional because the paper filter is below. So perhaps we could wash this one and we could reinstall it. A quick look around. I found out there is some oil inside. According to this dipstick, it shows. Somewhere halfway. Okay, it looks like the crank of the one cylinder engine is below here. Then here, I don't know if it's gear reduction or chain reduction, but then gear or the chain drives the hydraulic pump, which is behind here. This is the suction line, it's from the bottom from the hydraulic storage tank. Then pump delivering pressure via the discharge line. Discharge line is going here via connection. Then going to the switch. If you don't activate the switch, then the oil will go straight back to the tank. And if you activate the switch, then the oil will flow via the above line to the motor, spinning the motor around, going back, I think again to the return line, going back to the tank. So it's all quite simple. I need to check, of course, the oil also here. I guess it's the oil level. Yeah, next job is to take off the petrol tank, have a look inside, clean it. I checked it inside and it's empty, but it looks also quite rusty, so if I now fill it with clean petrol, then all this rust and stuff will go inside the fuel line and maybe it will cause some problems with the carburetor. So I prefer to take it off, clean it inside, clean the rest of the engine also, because so I managed to clean this little go-kart. Next thing to do is remove this petrol tank. So next thing to do is remove the fuel line via the little clip there. So that's off. Now we should be able to remove the tank and the line. Yeah, like that. So here it is, a little gas tank. I will clean it up, clean the inside, and put it back. Fuel tank is cleaner from inside. I put some fresh gas oil inside and shake it, and then all the crap came out. It's now on the bottom there. I also disconnect the fuel lines from the filter. I blow it also out with air. It looks clean. It's still the original filter, made in USA. So now it's time to put it back and put it back on the car. So here is the carburetor. It's completely disassembled. The reason why I took it apart is because it was leaking. All the fuel was running via the carburetor and it was draining somewhere on the bottom. So now it's laying here in parts. I clean all the parts. The gasket unfortunately broke, so I made a new one. And now it's time to put it back together and see if it will work. Now everything is back together again. It's still working. So next time I will put in some gas and we will try if it will run. If this one is running, we can continue with the plane. Thank you.